Hello, my name is Doug Leisure, and I'm recording this video to introduce you to the latest version of the software for recording donations at a church or other faith-based organizations. This software uses a lot of Excel formulas, but it also uses Excel VBA code, so it does require a full version of Excel on a PC or a Mac. All right, let me start with a very high-level demonstration overview of the software so that you can decide whether this might be something you can use at your organization and whether or not it's worth continuing to watch this video. All right, so we start with a large number of parameters that allow you to customize this for use at your church or your organization. Things like the name of the church, the address, whether you're reporting monthly or weekly, those kinds of parameters that you can adjust. And then we also have a list of donors. And so we organize those by envelope number or donor number. And a free form area that you can just continue to fill in and add to the list of donors. The main part though is on the entry screen. So each time we receive a donation, we start here, and we always start with the date. So let's say we're doing a donation on February 4th, 2022, and then basically we just start walking our way down through the donation that we've received. All right. So the first donation we have is from Natalie Stevenson, and she's in our list as donor number 2. So we put in the number, and she actually gave us two $5 bills. So that's that cash amount is $10. All right, and then the next thing we do is we just look at how does she want that recorded, what funds or categories. And so she said she wanted $5 in the general fund and $5 in missions. So that's just how simply we can record the information. Let's do it again for the next person. So this is Eliana McKenzie. She's donor number 3. Okay, so we put in the donor number, make sure that the lookup returns the right name, and then we see that she gave us a check for $100. So in the check amount, we entered $100, and optionally you can enter the check number, 1055. All right, just real quick. You notice that her name is red because this record or this row is out of balance. All right, we've received money, but we haven't distributed it correctly into the different categories. All right, so she said she wanted that to be distributed into the general, $50, into missions, and into the building fund. The red goes away once it's in balance. Just a simple little technique, but it helps to make sure that as we're going through person by person, that we keep things in sync or in balance as we move through, so we don't get to the end and then find out that everything's out of balance. All right, let's just do a couple more so you can see how this works. All right, the next thing we have is Emmy Shaw, and she's donor number 4. And she gave us a $10 bill as well as a check. So we have our $10 in cash, and the check was for $50. And again, optionally recording, $50 in check, and optionally recording the check number, 651. All right. And then Emmy said that she wanted us to do $50 to general, but also then $10 to a special donation that we're doing, special offering for Vacation Bible School. So we enter the amount and a description or a comment, and then we move on to the next one. All right, we also had some contribution that was in the offering plate, if you want to think of it that way, but it had no name because it's just sitting there kind of like loose. So we enter that as person 100, and that's what we just do for, that's the assigned number for loose offering or anonymous giving. And we just look at it, and we have 120, a 10, and 3 $1 bills. So we enter $33 cash, and that For our loose offerings, we always put that in the general fund. All right, next we have Eliana again. So she gave two contributions on that same day, donor number 3. And her second donation was a $20 bill and a $5 bill, so $25 cash. And she wanted that to go to that special offering for Vacation Bible School. All right. And then finally, just to, as our final example, is Dylan Snow. He's donor 101. And he actually did an online donation of $100. So we have a category here, a column for any type of electronic fund transfer, credit cards, online, Venmo, any of those kinds of things. So his $100 contribution, and he said he wanted it split evenly. So we just do the $25 across all four categories. All right, hopefully that gives you an idea of just how simple it is to do the entry part of it. A critical part of receiving donations is to make sure that you record things by person and by category, but also to make sure that you can balance the funds received to those categories and those amounts. So down here we have a place where we can enter the cash received, and we did it very simply by letting Excel do the mathematics, right? So we just simply count. How many ones did you receive? Well, we received 3 ones. How many fives did you receive? Well, we received 3 of those. How many tens? 2 of those. How many 20s? 2 of those. And a lot of times when you have volunteers helping you with this, with the contributions, you know, that's sometimes counting the money, the cash, is where you run into mistakes. But anybody should be able to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and count the quantity rather than counting the dollar amount. Let Excel do the math. All right, the red went away. That means our cash is in balance, and we come down to the checks. And currently it's out of balance until we enter the checks. So just simply read off the checks that we received in any order. So we had a check for 100. We also had a check for 50. And now everything is in balance. All of the red has disappeared. All right. The final part of this overview is to show you that this information is printed out for you. And this basically becomes your bank deposit information. Also, we print out the summary information at the bottom that tells us about the monies received and the categories. All right, so we have $100 came in through the EFT, electronic fund transfer, $228 that will be deposited in the bank, and this is the distribution, $163 in general, $55 in missions, $50 in building, $25 in benevolence, and $35 in specials. Okay. Now, when we print it, we will update this this pivot table at the bottom, but I'll just go ahead and do it manually so you can see that that what it does down here is, using the description of the comment, it gives us a list of the special or specials, if you do multiple specials in the same donation, their name and the total amounts. And this is what gets printed out. So. And when you're done, then we use the custom menu to say, hey, we're done with our entry, which is option number 1. Save everything and print the donation information. So go ahead and do that real quick. Yes, we want to save it and print it. Would you like to print it? Actually, I'm not connected to a printer right now. Or at this point, I don't want to print it. I'll save that for a later step. So I'll just say no to the printing, but yes to the saving. So, all right, a backup copy of the donation information for that day was saved in this folder, this file name, and we're done. Okay, that's a high-level overview. Hopefully you can see just how simple it is to use the software. Now let me circle back, though, and dig in a little bit deeper into some of the options and the capability that is here. All right, so let's go back to the parameters. I mentioned that at the beginning that this is where you can customize it for your church. So a lot of parameters here that allow you to customize it without changing the underlying code at all. So the year that you're recording for, you're receiving your donations, the church or organization name, information about what you would put on the receipt header, receipt footer, especially for a 501c3, the treasurer's name, whether you want your receipts to be displayed monthly or weekly. There's even an option for details, a detail printing, which includes those check numbers if you want to do that. Whether or not your reports are displayed weekly or monthly. An option here to say whether or not you're using the software on a PC or Mac, because the Excel on the two different platforms is actually a little bit different, so we need to know which one you're doing. We also have an option in here for you to use the software not only in English, but for you to be able to customize it to a different language. All right, and so when you choose the custom language, then the language that you've defined will be displayed here. So all of the information, the menu items, everything will be displayed in that other language. So since we're on that topic, let's go ahead and just take a quick look at how that works. So there is a tab here for translation, and basically we have everything here that we need in the English language, and an opportunity for you to convert that to a different language and paste your custom language in these yellow cells. To get started, I think the easiest way to do it is just to take a lot of this information, run over to Google Translate, throw everything in there, choose your language, right? And once you have the language, take the resulting language and just bring it back to this yellow cell in the translation tab, and paste in your translated language. Did I get everything here? Oh, sorry, I think I went too far. Paste in the translation. Now, Google does a pretty good job, but not a perfect job. So you do want to look closer after you've done the translation. Make sure these words here make sense in your designated language. Once you've done that, then you come back here to this parameter and switch from English to custom, and it'll start to display everything in that translation that you've entered. Okay. The other thing here is a keystroke that you can use, either using this quick access toolbar shortcut, or you can use a keyboard shortcut. So here's where you define that the letter that you want to use to bring up the custom menu. Now, the reason we have all the VBA code and the custom menu, again, because a lot of the times we have volunteers helping us out with this part of it, and they typically aren't Excel or proficient or even knowledgeable in using Excel, maybe just some rudimentaries. So by having the custom menu and all the VBA code behind it, that means our volunteers can use this very easily without knowing a lot about Excel. All right, let's look at a couple more things. We have different categories or funds that you can set up, and you can name them, and you get to decide how many you want to use, up to 20. The other thing we have in here is for use in other countries, we have the option to switch to different currency. So here you define the coins and the bills for your currency and their values, and then how many you want to use, right? So if I wanted to switch this to, let's say if we're using the software in Brazil, then I would just simply switch all of this to their currency. And here we need 12 rows to display that correctly. All right? And then that translates directly over here to this cash entry portion. Okay, so that again, that just allows us to very quickly and easily use this with different currencies. Just put it back to what it was. Okay, so that shows you the parameters and how much customization you have available just by filling in the parameters and adjusting them for your organization. Okay, the next thing, just wanted to circle back to the list of donors. So this is pretty much kind of a free-form list. You just keep simply adding to this a donor number. Maybe if you use envelopes, you would use their envelope number. You can also just simply kind of randomly assign numbers, not a big deal. But we have a donor number, name, optionally address, and optional email address. And you just, again, just keep adding to this list as you get new donors. The other thing that's important to understand is as you are doing your donation entry and we're done with it, we take all of that information and we copy it over here to this tab that's kind of like the running list of all of the donations. And so this will end up being a multi-year set of information. And so it's important that everything is correct here, because everything else we do from this point on is using the annual tab, the information on the annual tab, to drive all of the other things. One of the things we do is we can create either a monthly or a weekly report. So this just simply takes for the current year 2022 and breaks down all of the donations to the different categories by the total amount received in that month or in that week if you're doing the weekly version of it. In a very similar way, at the end of the year, and then of course we have the option to print your monthly reports or weekly if you're using that. And then the other thing, at the end of the year, we want some way to easily generate those year-end receipts for our donors, and that's what we have over here. So kind of this format we use, and when you use the menu option to print the receipts, it just goes through a list of all of your donors and prints off this information. Again, your choice, whether it's a monthly total, weekly subtotals, or there's an option for a detailed list, which would include the check numbers and the cash amounts and the checks and that kind of detailed information. Finally, we have a 5-year summary. So looking back over the past 5 years, what are our donations in total, and a graph so we can see it visually how things compare. All right, that should give you a pretty good understanding of how the software works. Down in the description, you'll see a link. You'll see my email address. If you're interested in getting a copy of this for your church or faith-based organization, just send me an email, and I'll be happy to send you a copy of it. All right, that's what I wanted to share with you. Thanks, and I hope you have a great day.